There is another way of solving systems of equations. It's called addition or elimination. If there is no lone variable, it may be better to use this addition or elimination method. This method works by adding the left and right sides of the equation together. In example 1, we see that negative 8x minus 3y equals negative 12. And our second equation is 2x plus 3y is equal to negative 6. If we think about this, we see that the 3y's are opposite signs of each other, but would work beautifully for addition, since if we added them together, they would drop out. So, let's do that. We're going to add the like terms together and see what happens. Negative 8x plus 2x gives me negative 6x. Negative 3y plus 3y gives me 0, so I won't write anything there. Negative 12 plus 6 gives me negative 18. If I divide both sides by negative 6, I get x is equal to 3. Once I have 3, I can take either one of my original equations and substitute for x. I'm going to take the first equation, negative 8x minus 3y is equal to negative 12. Notice that I've substituted 3 in for x. This gives me negative 24 minus 3y is equal to negative 12. Adding 24 to both sides, I get negative 3y is equal to 12. Dividing by negative 3, gives me y is equal to negative 4. I now have both the x value and the y value. So, my coordinate point is 3, negative 4. In example 2, I have a similar situation. Notice that the second equation has a positive 5x, and that will give me two terms that will easily drop out. So when I add my like terms together, one column at a time, my negative 5x and positive 5x add to 0. Moving on to my terms with y, I have 9y minus 6y, which gives me positive 3y. And 29 minus 11 gives me 18. Dividing by 3 on both sides allows me to solve for y. Y equals 6. I can then take 6 and plug it into either one of my original equations. I'll pick the first one. Negative 5x plus 9 times 6, or y, equals 29. Negative 6x is negative 6x plus 9 times 6 gives me 54 equal to 29. Subtracting 54 from both sides gives me negative 5x equal to negative 25. Dividing by negative 5 on both sides, I get x is equal to 5. So once again, my coordinate point solution, where x is equal to 5 and y is equal to 6. This gives me 5, 6 as the coordinate point or the values for x and y, or where the lines intersect each other on a graph.